So before you start CFP post, make sure that the entities that you want to plot in CFD post are actually being transferred from Fluent. And you can do that either under file, data file quantities, or you could highlight run calculation, select data file quantities, and make sure the static pressure, the total pressure, the Mach number, and total temperature are selected. And then OK. And then start CFD post by double clicking on results here. I've already done that. And if you want to, force Fluent to transfer data to CFD post, just run one iteration in CFD post and you'll get a refresh here. And you can read in, it'll read in the Mach number data and so on. And within CFD post, you can first create a location corresponding to the axis. And let me call this axis. Okay, it doesn't like axis, so I'll call it my axis. And that goes from minus 0.5, 0 to 0.5, 0, and apply. And if you go to the 3D viewer, it highlights the line that we just created, so that's right. And you may need to click on Z to view along Z over here. And then I need to create a line along the wall. That I'll do using location, polyline, I'll call this my wall. And I will create this using boundary intersection, the intersection of, whatever named label I have with periodic one. And it highlights the second my wall in green. Then I go to chart and say I can give it a suitable name. And under data series, I scroll down here. So first I'll plot the value at the axis. So that's what will be used in the legend. And I'll say location is my axis. And along the horizontal axis, I want to plot the axial distance, which is x. And along the vertical axis, I want to plot the Mach number. Apply. Okay, so that gives me the Mach number variation along the axis. Now let me plot the Mach number variation along the wall. So I'll go back here on Data Series tab, New Series, and I'll call this wall, and location is my wall, and apply. Okay, so it distinguishes with the legend between the two curves. And then I want to compare the quasi 1D solution to this. So I will create a new series, and I'll call this quasi 1D, and this I'll read from a file which you can download from the web page on which this video is embedded. So browse to the right folder and click the CSV file downloaded from the web page and apply. So that gives you the comparison with the between the analytical and the Fluent solutions. And if I go on the line display and double click on quasi 1D, I can turn off the line for this and plot it using symbols, which is a nice way to represent the comparison. And you can go in and, tweak the settings under these tabs to get a nice professional looking plot.